trying to... Well, it was... Well, what I thought was... 2 weeks from today, at the convention center, he'll be there. Oh, Rosie, thank God you've come. It's the end of the Almay New Music Corporation. Conrad Purdy's going into the Army.
And your faithful secretary is hereby submitting her resignation.
Huh?
I just dropped by to say goodbye, Albert, darling. Lots of luck.
Rosie, you can't. Not today of all days. My pills. My pills. Where are my pills? Oh, you know, the little white ones I take when I'm overwrought.
Here.
Oh, not so much. Break it in half.
You're 33 years old, Albert. You can take a whole aspirin.
I am not 33. I'm a long way from 33. I won't be 33 until tomorrow.
It's no use, Albert. My mind's made up. I've been with Alma you 8 years now, and as you well know, I've been a lot more than just a secretary to you.
Rosie, those were moments of madness.
Well, between the moments of madness and the office, I put in a good 90-hour week. And for what? A $5 raise in 1954 and a bottle of arcade last Christmas.
Promise her anything for a few months. You girl are
engaged. Yeah. But not a 16th of an ounce. Besides, I want something more than that.
Okay, you're speaking of a more permanent nature between you and I. I'm just not ready for it. Besides, there are the religious differences.
Spanish is not a religion.
And if it's part of the comedy you're after, the answer's no to that, too. How may Lou is me, Mama, and Lou. And any change in that would break the heart of that poor woman before me.
Nothing can kill your mother, Albert, except maybe a silver bullet.
And I won't drop more on Lou either. He loved you, Rose.
I love Lou, too. Sure, he was warm. He was loyal. He was lovable. But he died 6 years ago, and he was a wire-haired terrier. Besides, he's not a part of the company I want. This is much bigger.
If you're going to discuss what I think you're going to discuss, I'm in no mood to discuss it.
There's nothing to discuss, Albert. Conrad Bird is going in the Army. I quit. There's nothing you can do but quit.
Rosie, I'm up to my ears in debt. Conrad's got a $50,000 guarantee, which I can't pay. Severe overdose of aspirin.
Albert, this may be your last chance. Will you listen to me, Albert? I'm serious. It's going in.
couple of years, but I'm sure by 90 that'd be 3 or 4, but...
What are you doing?
Something that's going to push that date up a few years.
Pick a name.
Pick a name?
I don't know. All right, I'll do it for you.
McAfee. Kim McAfee, age 15, president and recording secretary of the Con Rafferty Fan Club, number 2748, Sweet Apple, Ohio.
Mary? Would you get me Sweet Apple, Ohio, please? The number is capital 7-8820. And call me right back.
What's going on here? Who's this Kim
McAfee? Kim McAfee, Albert, is what's going to send you back to college with the biggest kick-off business has ever seen. It's called One Last Kiss.
I've never heard of it.
Well, you haven't been there yet. But when you do, and when that one last kiss is from Conrad Birdie on his way into the big, cold army for 2 long years, and he gives that kiss to one of his fans, chose that rag from 1,200,000 hysterical teenagers, he'll make Mr. Birdie the hottest soldier since Joan of Arc!
Rosa, I'm beginning to see it. We'll cut the record in New York.
Send that long-haired guitar playing mommy to Sweet Apple.
I'll have to kiss that kid, can you?
And release the record.
Albert,
you make enough money to stay in college the rest of your life.
It's going to be great, Rosie. And I promise, as soon as we're in the clear, it'll be just you and me, Rose. In perfect bliss. Bliss? Kiss? Hey, fine. I wonder if anybody's used it before. Nah, it won't make any difference.
But one last kiss. It gives me so much bliss. You are so hard. That's a great.
Thank you. I was 18 in World War II.
Conrad Bertie, he's coming here to kiss me?
Thank you.
that crumb on the wall. What are you doing here?
Getting our things down to the station without any help from you, Elmer.
You know how the dancing is. I suppose a generous tip won't make things up.
Just take the briefcase and get down to the station before the reporter talk to Conrad alone. You remember what happened the last time?
Oh, Rose, you take it. I have to wait for Mama.
Speaking of your mother, Albert, did you get a chance to tell her about dissolving all my news?
I couldn't, Rose. Yesterday was the end.
Of what?
Six years ago yesterday, you struck down on 181st Street in Broadway by a loaded feeder truck.
Yoo-hoo!
Oh, you don't suppose that's Mama, dear?
It's either her or the all clear.
A mother can ride in a dirty, crowded subway full of foreign people who wouldn't give you a seat. Right. What's the difference?
Nowadays, mothers are lower than age.
There's a money I saved by not taking the test. By something. Who's she?
Come on, you remember Rose Alvarez from the office?
This is Rose Alvarez? Pretty little Rose Alvarez?
I can't believe it.
Rosie, what happened? You had a sudden shock or something?
Albert? I think I'll go see if Conrad's here.
By all means, Miss Alvarez. Son, look how nice she is. It's a wonder some older man hasn't snatched her up.
Maybe you better sit down.
Why? I know my sonny boy. He wouldn't say anything that would break Mama's heart. What about Lou?
It's about Lou, too.
Lou? Where are you, Lou? Struck down by a beverage I consumed faithfully for 32 years. What about Lou?
That I should give up Al May Lou.
Oh, Mama. What's the matter? Nothing's the matter. You just killed me, that's all. Lou, I'm coming. I'm on my way up.
Mama, you don't understand. It's just that never mind. Here's some money. Take a taxi. The subways are way too crowded.
Nothing is too crowded for mother. I'll take the IRT. It's the worst subway. Wait. How many blocks is it after all? Only 107. How long? Mama. Enjoy yourself, son. Take care. Wear it in a coat. Be careful when crossing the street. Put your money in your inside pocket. Wear your rubbers. I need a hot lunch.
Come on, Mom.
I thought you were going to break it to her gently.
Oh, well, as a matter of fact, Rose, I didn't tell her at all. I mean, she was so upset about my leaving that I thought it better wait.
You didn't say it.
He's coming! He's coming!
Later, Rose.
Okay, now are you ready?
Oh.
Mary, goes around kissing somebody else. That's what's so important. I'll have you know, I'm quite upset about this. I've already had several headaches.
And a nosebleed.
But you know, I think you're actually jealous of Conrad Bertie.
Me, jealous? I'm the opposite of jealous. I'm very jealous. Besides, I have every right to be. Kim's my steady.
But that's just it, Hugo. I'm your steady. Oh, I may admire Conrad Bertie as one admires a far distant and unattainable ideal. But I'm mean to you, Hugo. And no matter how common and ordinary you are, that's what you're going to say.
You're not just saying that to make me feel better.
Conrad Bertie is just a place. A study is forever.
Yeah! Coming! Coming!
He's coming! How are you holding it?
Yeah. office for a moment and forget about the Ed Sullivan Show. But something really important to tell you. It's about you and I.
You and me, English teacher?
Oh, Rose, I'm serious. I mean, ever since you, I, me, ever since we've been out here together, away from New York, I see things in a whole new light. That's why I wrote Mama and told her that no matter what, I'm giving up Alma and Lou.
Oh, you didn't?
I did, Rose. I wrote her 3 days and 3 nights ago, so... And today's life is 3 days and 3 nights. So why not then? I guess she's accepted the whole thing. What was that? Come in.
Nights on the trailway bus. I'm only a mother. And for a mother, a trailway bus is good enough.
Oh. Mama, what are you doing here?
You didn't think I'd come. A woman gets a letter obviously written under the influence of drugs that she should. Only a mother's tears. Dear Al, Mom, this is to let you know that Al Mayhew is dissolved. Your friend, Al. Dissolve Al Mayhew? Dissolve me? Who am I anyway? Some sick old woman who probably won't last through the night. I just want the simple headstone with one word carved on it. Albert's mother. And don't forget to hire a limousine to take me to my final resting place. I'll walk. Mama, and you can tell that Spanish friend, I forgive her. She know not what she knows.
Mama, Rose is right here.
Mrs. Rose? I can't believe it. She looks like Margot when they took her out of Shangri-La. For her own sake, Albert, send her back to Tibet. And don't worry about a secretary. It so happens a man on the bus, a wonderful secretary, a refined girl, who was on her way to Akron until I persuaded her to get off here.
Do you use the touch system?
Whatever possible! to insist on the new Kodak. And now the young man you've all been waiting to see. As you know, in just about 14 hours, one of Shu Business's brightest talents is going off to play a very special engagement. And tonight, before he goes, he wants to leave a certain lucky young lady with one last kiss. Ladies and gentlemen, we take you now to Sweet Apple, Ohio, where a typical American family, Mr. and Mrs. Harry McAfee, and their children, Rudolph, Randolph, and Kim, are schlepping together to bid farewell to a typical American shoulder, Conrad Birdie.
Thank you. And by
back, stop by the kitchen. Take my head out of the oven and turn off the gas. Never mind. It's a strange house and I don't want to run up the bill.
Mama, I've had enough of this. If you really loved me, you'd help me find Rosie. Who knows what dive she's in this very moment? She's out there making up for all those years she's wasted on me.
Oh, Sonny, you're right. I should give you a message from Comrade.
Message? What message?
Nothing to worry about. He just says he's going out this evening, and he may not be back in time to kiss him tomorrow.
Oh, my God. No, it's easy. Comrade!
Take it easy. I'm coming.
Now.
Before you start hollering at me, Albert, I want to let you know I've made up my mind. I'm tired of getting up at 9 every morning. Having people watch me while I eat, and have a kid poke me in the eye. You want to have some fun? Come on. Give me a couple of chicks. Don't you understand, Albert? I'm tense.
Just don't stand there. Something.
Come back. Have you ever considered a war?
My last free night before I go into the army, and I'm going out.
You're not going out anywhere. That's so in your contract. Mom, get my contract. It's in my brief. Okay. Oh, never mind. I'll get it.
All shiny and new. Got a girl
kick myself dead.
Moonlight swims, motorboat races, loop to loop, Doris, get my gun.
Oh, Mr. Rafferty, you haven't seen Carmen, have you?
No, I haven't, but I intend to, Mr. Peterson, and so if you have a message, I'll be glad to deliver it right after I shoot him.
Shoot him? I've got to find Rosie.
Dear, what are you talking about? You don't have a gun.
There's that Daisy air rifle in the garage. You shut up. Wonder where I can find Phoebe's this late at night.
Anyway, it's coming, dear.
Well, it can be anything. There's that bow and arrow that I bought you last Christmas with the suction tips. Don't just stand there. My daughter can run off the loop to loop without pain. Give me a water gun.
Kids, with their awful clothes and their broken rules. For men only, that's right. And now, before the recording secretary reads the minutes, from last week's meeting, I'd like to bring up a topic which I'm sure is on everyone's mind. The topic.
The sun is running around the saloons of the Mexicali Road to
Yes, little boy.
Good night, Mom.
Just like your father, you marry anything.
Why?
Well, Conrad, isn't it? The Ice House. Fun, isn't it? Of course, when you've been here as many times as I have, I've been here with just everybody, you know. Deborah Sue, Ursula, the Girl Scouts. Stronger than the chocolate ones, aren't you? Conrad, you seem a bit nervous. Maybe a dry eye on this would relax you. Perhaps one of those reapers I've read so much about. If you want, I can go out and get you a fix. If you tell me what it is. I mean, when you've had a donkey on your back as long as I have. Conrad, you're traveling. Just because you're a few years younger than I am. I'm 27 or 28, you know, one of the two. So you see, I really know the score. I even know some of the words. Canubian, premarital, jailbait. Oh, there you are, oh, sensuous one. We've been looking for you everywhere.
Get out of my way. That's great, but I'm late.
But you don't understand. We're coming with you. You said it yourself. We've got a lot of living to do.
No, wait a minute.
What? We'll never go home again. We'll follow you to the end.
Adios, Mama. Adios.
Promise of each other.
since where I come from is Allentown, PA.
Okay, Nate, I'll be Spanish. Just wait till I marry Alabama.
I'll be the ghost of Chichi from the Narco. And all their love my cats and then we clean.
I won't worry about you.
And don't worry about the cook. You'll have three first stories as soon as the train passes over.
Just a moment, Mr. Peterson. I demand to know what you've done with Mr. Burdick. Oh, he is not down in the jail.
I don't know where Mr. Burdick is. I've been here for my brother.
Mr. Peterson.
Oh, now, dear. Now, there's nothing to be upset about. After all, there's no harm done. Kim and Hugo are back together again. Proposed to her, and she accepted him.
Oh, dear,
that was wrong.
My life is over. I'll sell the house and move into a home.
All aboard!
At the Pumpkin Falls Junior High School. I read about it in this morning's paper. They want somebody to teach English and domestic science. Oh, and they prefer the applicants to be married, so I'm hoping to write a document.
Oh, Albert!
I was never crazy for flowers. I confess that nothing left me colder. I'd watch a daisy for hours, and all I feel was several hours older. Lilacs and lilies, daisies, all that they did was make me shrug or sneeze. But now I've loved the blossoms that I see. For me. Now my life is rosy, since I have my Rosie, with a girl like Rosie, how could I be, hand in hand with Rosie, me and little Rosie, we will be so cozy by
You also know that, all of our, cast and our, help, our volunteers, they spend their, evenings there with me because they love theater. And, as you can see, it's a lot of fun. At this point, a lot of times we save this for our cast party after. We'd like to share this with all of you tonight. Some people who couldn't have done this without. And brought them up here with, brought all but one. Not that this is around here, but the other night, Sharon, having a major fight, we went backstage and somebody was coming.